Here we are at the Embankment Club, just waiting for the early arrivals, all ready to go. Tonight's DJs are Dave Vanner from Rushton, Cheer Up and Ketchum, and Bob Hensley from Bolton up near Manchester. Should be a good night, so enjoy the film, and here's the third anniversary.
Sparky, it's very nice to meet you, everyone.
I'm Mick.
And that's Mick from Northampton. We're both from Northampton. Both got into Northern Soul through school. I met this geezer through moving to London to Northampton in an overspill situation. Went to school, young Mick here, at the time young, I don't know about now, he's a bit older.
He's still young.
We're still young at heart. At the end of the day, I looked at him and I thought, that boy can move, and it was all down to the dancing at the time. I mean, the music was secondary at the time, as soon as I started listening to it on a full-term basis. Then you start getting the taste of the music, which is unbelievable to some people. You play it to people and they think, come on, mate, we're talking 60s and very naive. I said, you're not even listening to their voices, the way they sing a record, the way they come across with it. Every song's got its own storyline.
Who's your favourite?
And they're
DJ?
All unknown artists.
What,
a lot of
in Wellingborough?
You know.
Of all time.
Of all time.
What was that question, mother?
Who's your favourite DJ?
Well,
so many.
Brian Ray, at the end of the day, means a lot to me in my heart, because basically wherever Brian was, I was. I mean, not through me following him.
Soul sounds good.
It was right, yeah, soul sounds.
Been about years.
But the old days, going back to 76, 75 here, must be that many.
Lenny's all right as well.
Lenny's good for them. I'm an old reminiscer at heart. Mickey's into the new stuff and he'll get into it all day long and listen to all. Me, I love coming to the clubs just to remind me of my teenage days at the end of the day and see people that I was brought up with in them days. And I don't do it on a crazy situation. I do it because life is better that way than it is me meeting new people. I'm safe with my old crowd. you know, at the end of the day, these Northern Soul people in here are peace-loving people more than any hippie I know. You know, you know what I'm saying?
All the hippies are dead.
I have been to Soul Dudes years ago, and I've never seen one fight barring the outside people starting fights when they come out of their pubs.
That's true.
And they hate soul heads, and we hate soul heads. We're going to kick some soul, isn't it? And they always come off worse in the end, because we're very gentle, but we don't take no bollocks or shit, pardon the swearing. But we're not violent people at heart. We come to these clubs from all different areas of the country.
You've come up from Reading,
haven't you? I've come to Reading tonight.
What about the Embankment Club? What do you like?
The Embankment Club, great, because everyone meets up the same people. Nicky, I'm talking too much, you cranky, mate.
No, you're all right, you carry on.
Everyone meets up.
Keep working out.
Everyone meets up at that club, Lenny's club, that he's got going here, and he plays a mixture of music.
Every time he has one, the attendance gets better and better. You
know,
better DJs.
I mean, he's doing something
brilliant.
Right.
It's just good.
You know,
the best
the
one
day,
in the area.
It's
definitely
a safe area to come to, in the sense the people are safe. We all know each other through clubs around the country. It's not like we're all meeting strangers all the time. The Midlands downwards crowd, we all know each other through the clubs.
Yeah.
So everywhere we go each week, I haven't been for a few weeks, but I'm back. You know, with a vengeance, I believe. Every time we go each week, we meet the same crowd of people, so it's
like a family.
We all go to work during the week, and then come Friday night, if we've got enough money, we'll get in the car and we'll shoot off to the soul night or an all-nighter. And basically, you let your hair down, forget about work, forget about all
you
life. I mean, you've heard this has been said loads of times on other soul videos, but it's the truth. You know, I mean, I'm in debt for £1,000. Not me, but this could be anyone. This is an example. I'm in debt for £1,000. Let's go to a soul night. And forget about the £1,000, we'll worry about it tomorrow when we come home and the bailiffs are ready to kick our heads in.
Yeah, you're right.
You know, basically, the music, once it's in you, it's like soul comes from deep within. I mean, it will turn a grown thug of a man, and I mean a violent man, into a puppy dog at the end of the day. I mean, you know, what I'm getting at, there's no aggro at these dudes, but it could, if a grown thug, as in thug, skinhead, whatever, a violent man, wouldn't mind thinking twice about, no I'm not, punching someone in the face, comes to a soul dude, that's the last thing on his mind. I mean, all he's into, if he's got soul in his body, is that music. And it's, I can't explain it, and I've tried to explain it to so many people in the past. And I can't get it through to them, because they don't want to accept it. Basically, we're brought up with it from 15 onwards. It's like being brought up with pop music. I mean, I love the Spice Girls, but bless them, you know.
It's got that on the video, it's proven, mate.
Let's have some questions, definitely.
What's your all-time favourite record?
My all-time is that one. It was at one stage. That's a... It's called Jimmy Man and My World Is On Fire. That was my all-time favourite record at one stage. Now, I'm sick to death of it and I hate it with a vengeance. No, not really. I would never hate it. I love it dearly. What I mean is, you need a change, you see. Personally, I'm a reminiscer, but I will soon get sick of reminiscing.
You get favourite records at the time.
Your favourite at the moment?
So you go round in a sort of circle of like getting into something, then
it changes every time. You can't pinpoint it.
Every time I come back, I hear another record that I haven't heard. Because I give it up for 15 years and came back to the scene through a letter from an old friend who didn't even know who I was. He saw me in a magazine. But that's another story, you know. What I mean is, I got back into it and I'm really pleased I did, because for 15 years it's been playing on my mind, what are my friends doing, what's going on in the Northern Soul scene, where has it gone? I didn't know, I lost complete contact with it, because I lived in a place called London, and there ain't none down here, but bless his heart, AD, the Under Club, and a couple of little plastic Northern Soul places that were whacking a few sounds around Notting Hill Gateway, but barring that, you're completely cut away from it all. As soon as you hit the Midlands, you're into it. You know, it's there around, all right, at school. How many of us at school make into it?
Right.
you know, 20, no, hang on, let's not go mental. Everyone likes it, but who done it for serious sakes? You know?
Seven
Me,
us.
You, seven of us. Right. All told in Northampton, you'd probably be lucky if you had 20 Northern Soul Boys going to the nighters that could be in Wigan, Peterborough, it doesn't matter where it would be, we would be there. And if we wasn't, it wasn't through not wanting to be there. It was probably because we didn't have the money to get there, and we were too young to have that sort of money to be able to travel up there. And there was always a reason why. But at the end of the day, Northern Soul, you eat, breathe the other one, and you just live for it.
Oh,
and
great
it really,
to,
it's like
to
a religion.
Really,
it's a religion without a shadow of a doubt.
It's more of a way of life than that.
I mean, at the end of the day, we've all got problems, you know, all through life, everyone has, you know, but Northern Soul and the music will make you think, Mick, I love you, you know, listen to this, don't it just make you feel good, you know, it's brilliant, it's a buzz on its own, without anything, drink the lot, without anything like that. And at the end of the day, if my girls turned around and said, I want to be in the Northern Soul scene, Dad, I would basically give them my blessing. Because there's nothing wrong with it. All I can say is, like, there's no harm in it. I'd rather them there than at these raves that are going on and things like that. Anyway, that's another story, so we won't go too mad into that. Next question.
How long do you think the scene will keep going?
Forever. Well, there's people like him about his enthusiasm. It's going to go on forever, isn't it?
Basically, you need, with the enthusiasm of people in the Northern Soul scene, which is, I mean, I'm young, so some of them. You've got Brian Ray, I don't know how old he is, but he's a lot older than me. Brian was old when I was 15, and I'm not knocking old, because, like, what I'm saying is, a man is, for 55, it must be. You know, if not 50, for a 50-year-old man, whatever, I don't mind, it doesn't matter. Age is nothing, it's how you feel, and it's down to soul as well.
And they prove it.
And they prove it very well. I mean, they're all looking their age. Don't stop them getting up and going out in their cars and driving up the M4 or M1 or whatever, to all-nighters that are going on around the country, like kiddies do, like teenagers do. There must be something about this scene that makes a grown man of that age
carry on.
And it ain't just like he hasn't grown up, because that's rubbish. I mean, we've all grown up, we've all got, Mickey's got his own business, I've got my own business. You know, we're not silly kids, you know what I mean? What I'm getting at is, there must be something about this scene that keeps you going and going. But we're running out, because we're all getting older and we're all gonna die when we're about 70 or 80 or maybe 90, I don't know, but old age is going to creep up on us, and who is going to be left? All I can say is we've got to do something soon to attract the younger generation.
But Mick,
let's face it, you had times, I mean, you had days years ago, everyone, I'm talking thousands then, at Wigan, had all clapped once, and not at all until 20 seconds later when the next clap came in, and it'd all be on the same note. So the whole club would go wallop, one big loud clap. I mean, have you ever heard one big loud clap from everyone and nothing else? I'm right, we've all had rounds of applause. What I'm talking about is, bang, one big clap, everyone, at the right time of the beat. It's unbelievable. It's like everyone knows when to come in. All I can say is about Northern Soul, to keep it going, we've got to make these young kids interested. And
never.
It's nice to see some young people here at the Embankment Club. What do you like about this place?
I like the Embankment Club for the fact that you can tell it just hasn't changed over the years. I could imagine coming here perhaps in the late 60s or early 70s, and it's just got a typical, very good working class ethic about it. The fact that the, at one point the bar is cheap, that's obviously a major part of it. But I love the fact that an excellent dance floor with traditional seating and traditional tables, and the mirrored ball in the ceiling gives it just an unchanged ambience, really.
And the actual layout of it as
well. Absolutely.
Just a nice rectangular basic room.
How long have you been on the scene?
I've been a mod for 15 years, subsequently been going to the Northern Sides and mod days for that amount of time. So locally, to the Soul Days, for instance, I've been going now for a good 10 years now.
Can you remember your first Soul Night?
Yeah, very well, really. Would be 10 years ago, actually, this year, in Kettering, a place called North Park Workmen's Club, courtesy of Chiro. At the tender age of 16, really, with a gang of friends, and just dancing away.
How about an all-nighter?
First all-nighter? The first proper all-nighter would have been 86. That was a mod all-nighter, which was excellent. And Northern Soul all-nighter-wise, I think possibly my first proper one would have been 89, which was just fantastic, and been to quite a few since, really.
Is there anything you don't like about the
Northern Soul scene? Well, speaking personally for myself, I think others as well may have said this, in that, if I give you an example, at Northern Soul All-Nighter at 4 o'clock in the morning, when people are starting to flag perhaps a little, what you don't need, I think, is a DJ that comes on and just plays very slow, very slow, very moody records that just keeps people riveted to their seats. And also, you don't need DJs that just show off to other DJs and the records they've got. They don't play to the dance floor, they don't play to the people that actually want to dance. And it's very frustrating when you find yourself at 5 o'clock in the morning after an hour of listening to drony old music, when you think, well, you know, this is the perfect time you can really light up now with some classic oldies, and not necessarily the oldies that have been played 100 times on every single soul do. There's literally, without exaggerating, hundreds or possibly thousands of records you just don't hear anymore that were big, you know, many years ago that deserve some airplay nowadays.
Have you got a favourite DJ?
Favourites, really. There's many.
Yeah, not one particular, is
no,
there?
No, I think so many of them deserve recognition. And really, I presume to be called like the best DJ in the land is such a high accolade that I don't think anyone could really aspire to that. So, to give a few names off the cuff, really, I think nationally wise, Ian Jackson.
Yeah. Dave Anner from here.
Dave Anner, yeah. Plays some very good tracks. Well, there's too numerous to mention, really. They're all very good, absolutely.
Have you got a favourite record?
No, you can't ever. You can't ever pin it down. You can't ever. It's just absolutely too much. You could, I suppose, you could play a record at home and think this is my favourite, and absolutely love it. And the next record you put on, you've forgotten the last record, and you think, oh, I actually adore this record. It's fantastic, and so it just goes on, really. And it's, I suppose, in the end, it just becomes flavour of the month of what record you love. And like, but there are certainly some records that you can hear literally thousands of times and it sounds just as fresh as the first time you heard them, and that's when you've got an excellent record and you can just listen to it every time.
I think there is a group of records, isn't there, that both, we'd say both our favourites, a group of records, but that can be an any number, and there's certainly some that are less favourite than others.
And then as well, any style, I mean, you know, we love everything soul-wise from, you know, the late R&B of the early 60s, right through to the crossover in the 70s and 80s, and you know, perhaps even nowadays, there's some very good modern style records that don't get chart success, which is possibly good because we don't want people really, if they want to find some gold out there, they want to find it themselves. We don't want records to get into the charts and then just to find it by listening to it on the radio. So yeah, there's just certain types we like, and it just changes really.
How long do you think the scene's got?
They say it was going to have to fizzle out some stage, but there just seems to be still young people coming along. Not as many, but there's still young people all the time. So as long as that happens, it can go on and on.
I think, to put a date on it, if you want to put me, get me to put a precise date on it, I would say 2084, you might see it starting to run down a bit, actually. I mean, some of the DJs may not be around by that time, but, you know, the records will live on.
Thanks for talking to us.
Pleasure.
Think of the words, just sing along. Yeah, you watch it. Said you and I.
I've been on the scene since I was 18. And I'm now 35. But I did have a break when I had children, and I've come back, been back about 2 or 3 years. Mm. Yeah, about 2 or 3 years.
And I've been in it for about 15 years, I suppose. 13, 14 years.
Can you remember your first soul night?
No.
No?
Mine was a dayer, an all-dayer at St Ives.
Not an all-nighter, an all-dayer.
No, my first place I went to was an all-dayer, and that was at St Ives.
About
some years ago, about 15 years ago.
I think mine was at Wilby. I think there used to be a room in the top rear of the room.
A lot of people have mentioned Wilby.
Yeah,
George.
I think that's it, the George, yes. At Wilby. Yeah, that was the first soul night that she went to.
Is there anything you don't like about the Northern soul scene? Everybody's
no.
Very enthusiastic.
Absolutely nothing.
No, I can't think of anything.
Everybody seems so...
Perhaps sometimes the travel gets you down, because you have to travel so far.
Yeah,
the distances.
Occasionally, but I mean, that's part of the fun of it, isn't it, as
yeah,
well?
So. Yeah.
Have you made lots of friends?
All loads.
Through...
No, loads all over the country as well.
Yeah.
That's wonderful.
Yeah.
Have you got a favourite DJ?
Sooty.
Sooty. And I actually... Chiro.
Chiro.
But they all have their own, they're all very good, I think.
And what about your all-time favourite records?
Oh, gosh, I don't have one, No, I haven't.
You like them all?
Yeah, well, the majority.
How long do you think the scene will carry on for?
I can't see it ever ending. I mean, I've been going for, since I was 18. It does change, but...
The old faces go and come back.
Yeah, that's right. You can have people that probably don't go for 5, 6, 7 years, and all of a sudden you'll see them at soul night, and then they'll go again for a few years. They might have another break, but then they'll come back again. But it's addictive. You can't, once you start going,
you
want
to travel
keep
very far.
Well,
we've
been
going
to
Winsford.
Winsford.
And Manchester. So, that's about the furthest we've been. But Gloucester. We'll go down to Gloucester for a night.
It's a long way.
Yeah,
but
they are worth it.
Good.
She's not
thanks
convinced.
For talking to us.
She's thinking you're mad.
Thanks very much.
Bamboozled into this, so basically we were at the Embankment Club, an excellent venue, one of the best I've seen in the last 4 years I've been active on the scene. Embankment Club have been coming here for about 4 years, play a good cross sounds, 70s, 60s, everything, anything that you really remember as an oldie, and if you're current on the all-nighter scene, certainly the tunes are great in general, enjoy them. So that spurred me on to go to Kiel first all night. And never being out all night ever in my life, it was an experience that I'll never forget, and perhaps drove me and motivated me to go and promote my own night, because I wanted to just enjoy what I saw happening that night and share it with as many people as I could too. How long do you think the scene will keep going? Well, as long as there's crazy people like me that just enjoy getting out and meeting people and having a crack and dancing some good music. I suppose that's as long. They were doing it in the Stone Age, something like that. Who's your favourite DJ from past and present? Well, I can only talk the last 4 years. Who's your favourite DJ? Well, there's DJs and there's record collectors that play some cracking rare tunes. DJ, I'd have to say, would be Tony Della as a DJ. He inspired me first time I ever saw him, and after really 4 years and I've travelled the country not seen anyone DJ like Tony Della. Presents. There's too many to mention, and if I leave some out, I'm not going to be welcome at some venues around the country, so I better not say.
Last 45 minutes, yours truly. Pick up the old classic Monster Sound, especially with Mr. Hugh Kilmer. Thank you. Sam the Oldies, Julius Covey.
I like the people who come. Like I say, it's nice to be amongst people you feel comfortable with.
that is all of it.
How about your favourite record? Is there one special one?
Yeah, I've got to say it to the camera. Bernie Williams, Ever Begin, okay? the people who are going to watch this are going to go, oh, not that. Thank you. Been the Shays in Northampton, or the George at Wilby, just up the road here, or even the North Park Club in Ketchum.
Oh, it's endless amount of clubs we went to over the years. I think the George probably stands out as being perhaps the one of the most famous around here. All-nighter, the first all-nighter I probably went to and probably did was in 1969. That was the old Red Elks, just down the A43. They had a one-off all-nighter down there and had a chance to do a spot there and sort of went on from there. Now the Embankment Club, it's a great little place, this club is. It's not only become famous in the last 3 years for its soul scene down here, run by Lenny Dopson, but it's also famous for rock and roll down here. In fact, I think it's perhaps one of the most known places in the country at this present moment. Right, anything else you want to know?
Well, you're obviously very keen. How do you think you can keep it going?
At the moment, there's a lot of clubs around. At present, it's building back up again. It was back to what it was in the 70s. In fact, I would almost be fair to say that it's probably a little bit better than it was then. It's very popular right now. I think it'll be around for another couple of years like this, then I think over the next 2 or 3 years, I think one or two will drop off, and then the original and general followers will just cling to those few that are still going at the end of the day. I think it'll still last for long. We've still got plenty of time.
Have you got a favourite DJ?
I've got no favourite DJs. My DJs go way back. I mean, I was brought up with other DJs. I mean, my first early DJ career was in Northampton during the 60s. And one of the heroes over there is Mick Murphy. In fact, he's still on the scene. He does a lot of old soul-y dudes over there. And then there's Brian Tompkins and Alan Dobson from Ketchin, who was also influenced myself in the early years, who helped me in the right direction in those days. But today, I've got a lot of respect for any DJ that will try to break a new record and will also think of the dance floor and to keep them happy as well. I've got respect for most DJs on the scene today.
Have you got a favourite all-time record?
Oh dear. I can have a favourite record every week. there's so many great records. I mean, I like a nice beat ballad. I like a nice fast record. There's so many. I couldn't really pick one out of the air, really. I'm going to get back home tonight and say, "Brass, I've always liked that one. Why did I bring that up?" So many.
Well, thanks for talking to us. Hope you have a lovely evening.
I think it'll be a good evening. It's looking good already. Thank you.
So we thank all the DJs tonight, Dave Brown from Rushton, Cheery Kitchen and Bob Hinch. Give them a round of applause. Thanks for making a great night. Cheers. This one's Fred Harper, one of your song favourites, and wherever you were.
Wherever you were.
know.
How long have you been coming here?
Coming here for about 3 years, more or less, since I started.
And have you been on the scene for a long time?
Since 1977. It's a very, very young flat.
Can you remember what your first soul night was?
First soul night would have been a Saturday night, George and Dragon in Bedford. And then from there it went to the United, Williston, and all over around Northamptonshire. And George will be. Various other places, and then to the big all nights, and that was the start of a lifetime.
Where did you go for your all nights?
Started at the Torch in Stoke-on-Trent. From there, Wigan Casino, every other all nighter from there on, Samantha's in Sheffield, Colwyn Bay. Morecambe, Stafford, just about everywhere, St Ives. Never ever went down south to Yate. That was a bit sort of sacrilege going down south and then on the night when it was Morecambe.
Is there anything you don't like about the
Northeast? Don't particularly like people that take the mickey out of it. People can't understand. Not that I don't like it, I feel sorry for them not being able to understand it. Generally people who sort of say to themselves, well, you know, if I can do better than that, if they can do better than that, then do better than that by promoting their own soul life.
And how long do you think the scene's gonna keep going?
Well, I just come back from Cleethorpes weekend about a fortnight ago, and there was little kids dancing up there. And if there's an all day around, there's sometimes little kids there. So as long as they're still doing it, the girls are pleased to help them.
Great.
Have
you got a favourite DJ?
A favourite DJ?
Present or
not a favourite DJ, I would dance to any DJ that plays anything decent.
How about a favourite record?
Favourite record at the moment has got to be Christine Cooper Hives Away On Board. It's a real oldie that makes your hair stand up on the back of your neck every time you hear it right from the opening bars.
Is there any record you'd like to hear tonight apart from that?
Apart from that? It depends who's DJing. If it's someone who's got a good collection, then I'd like to hear something really good. Depends on what they've got.
Well, I hope you enjoy the rest of the evening.
Certainly will. We always do. Thanks.
Coming here since like virtually it started. I like the idea of the soul night rather than the going off to an all-nighter necessarily every week. One doesn't have to go off to an all-nighter every week. One just enjoys the music, enjoys the people, because it's the people that count. When all's said and done, the people actually make the scene. There's nothing else. These is what happens. You get a group of like-minded people and they're having fun. They're kicking it, they're out there enjoying themselves. They work all bloody week, so it's nice to, for them to relax. That's not a problem whatsoever. I think it's great. The Embankment Club is one of those places that it has a friendly atmosphere when you walk in. It sort of wraps itself around you and says, come on in, lad, and have fun. I mean, I come from the north, and it's quite surprising to come down to this far south and find that sort of atmosphere. I think it's wonderful. I mean, I've been doing this now for a reasonable number of years, and I like the place. It really is a nice place. It's comfortable, and the people are good too. What record would I like to hear? That's a difficult question. There's not one I'd particularly like to hear any more than any other. Something with a dance sound, as you can probably hear in the background, but something that makes me feel. Someone said to me once, what is it about Northern Soul or all-nighters that you like? I said, if I had to explain it, it's extremely difficult. It's like trying to explain sex to a virgin. You know, it's a nice idea, but like, if you don't feel it, you just ain't got it. That's my first soul nighter all-nighter. My first soul nighter was when I was like back when I was 14. I was living in Crewe in Cheshire at the time. Going through school, I left school at 15, stayed at home, did all the bits and pieces, and went to work. You know, 2 days after finishing school, I was working at a tannery in Nantwich in Cheshire. And weekends, what you work for, you live for, because you work in the drudgery all week. You can't go to a pub because you're too bloody young. Saturday nights, going to the Twisted Wheel, that was outrageous. My first all-nighter was Boxing Day 1968, when the Twisted Wheel in Manchester. It cost me 10 bob to get there on the train return, because we hadn't learned by that time to jump the trains. 10 bob to get in, and 10 bob for a bloody good evening. And I enjoyed myself all the way through to Wednesday, basically. I'm sure you all know what I'm talking about. I went to see Junior Walker and the All-Stars. My first real introduction to soul, apart from when I was like 14 years old and I was at the Cavern Club. And the week prior, 2 weeks prior, I'd heard Wayne Fontana and the Mindbenders doing their bits and pieces. And they did Oh Mum, Oh Mum, Mum. And then 2 weeks later, I saw Major Lance, and he did the original. I didn't know it was the original at the time. And all of a sudden, I thought, wow, that's totally different. And that made me find out what all the real ones were. And then you find out that the Beatles and the Stones, Wayne Fontana, and all the other ones were doing copies, covers, basically, of the quality sounds. And then I found out what the originals were, and that's what started me really speaking into soul when I was about 14 years old. And when I was 16, I went to an all-nighter, and just watching the wall sweat and watching the guy run up the wall and come over backwards and drop into a backdrop, I thought, I can do that. And I started doing it from then on. And I became basically one of the dancers who danced in the middle of these little circles that used to develop. I was one of those guys, and I loved it. I was at home. I was at home, and I'm still at home. 29 years later, I mean, Boxing Day 68, this is my 29th anniversary coming up. Wonderful. I can't tell you how good it really, really is. Apart from video interviews, I don't mind them. I've done them before. What I like about Northern Soul, it's the people. The whole thing is about enjoying what you do. I have no particular taste in music. I can enjoy myself at a hard rock concert, enjoy myself at biker rallies, weekends. It doesn't matter to me. It's the people that count, and these people are up on a par with everyone and everywhere I've ever been. I just think it's wonderful. There's something about, as I said earlier, a group of like-minded people coming on hard and enjoying themselves, really getting down and having a great laugh. Now, I think that is the be-all and end-all. The Embankment is one of those classic places where you get 150 people. You can get 60 people here, and the atmosphere is still as good because you're all of a mind. And that, to me, really speaking, is the best of it. Seriously. I know it's been very short, but thanks for asking me to be interviewed.
Goodbye, cooler. I ain't gonna worry about you. I can't afford to fall. again.